Welcome, my dear Oddites. Brand new junk store tour and brand new junk store, at least for you guys. I've been here before a few years ago and it was so crap I never came back for a few years, so I'm going to try again today and see if it's any better. I always had the feeling that the staff were somehow withholding. I just want to show you out the window here. It's not all sweet old ancient villages. We do have sort of industrial areas too here in Switzerland. So that's the view out the window. Yeah, so now, it was really bad before. It looks to be a lot better now from first glimpse. So I'm very... Aha! There she is, lurking in the corner as always. Every time I turn my back, I get the feeling there's a movement. I can't catch her. Never been able to catch her. One of these days. One of these days, my nemesis. So, what have we got here? What's that like? Is that a doctor's bag? 80 quid? I've had similar. But that must be the sort of leather soap to go with it. Doctor's soap? Doctor's soap? Oh, maybe it is a doctor's bag. Yeah, I've had one of these before. They're sort of Swiss Army backpacks. Covered in fur. They're quite common though. Now there's a really old typewriter. I had this incredible coughing woman. She kept following me around. I had to keep walking away. The next minute she'd appear behind me coughing away. 320 quid, that's a lot of money. Ah, there's a good disguise for me. Next time I come, the mannequin won't recognize me if I grab that. So any belly, belly dancers out there? Quite an eye-catching outfit, isn't it? Holy dooly. Yeah, I'm sure it looked good on someone. What have we here? Cutlery. Silverware. Doesn't interest me, but it might interest you. Well, that's a beautiful old plate. Is that a New Zealand power shell? It seems to be inlaid with type of shell. Maybe it's power shell. You tell me. Power shell? Am I pronouncing that correct? Power? I always thought it was power shell. Maybe I'm wrong. Now there's a beautiful old cash register. Isn't that gorgeous? Wow. That is fantastic. That's an old Swiss cash register. Isn't it beautifully decorated? They used to be quite the rage, didn't they, in the 80s? Everyone seemed to buy one of these. My sister had one too. But they take up space, and I guess if you had like a store or a shop, they would look good. Hey, do you remember this? Do you remember the video I went to Eglisau with the drink, the Vivi Cola? Well, there you go. There's one of the old crates for the bottles. Wow. Yeah, by the time you guys come to Switzerland, you'll know everything about it, won't you? From me. That's an old cast iron stove. It's quite nice, in good nick too. Beautiful old Chesterfield. Very nice. Now that's an old radiogram. It's defect, but it's in fantastic condition. $60 for defect. Okay, it's about its price. Yeah, that's a really nice old cabinet. 390. Now, it's huge. If you had the space, it's great value. It's all hand-carved. Fantastic. Someone's obviously restored that. It's got a beautiful gleam to it. You'd have to excuse me today, Oddites. I'm full of cold. Battling on. But my voice is a bit raspy because of that very reason. Now, here's an old hand-painted cupboard, which used to be very popular. I've mentioned this in other videos, for 300. You wouldn't get that on the internet. You'd get a lot less. As I say, it's very nice country style furniture, but the internet is sort of the measure of what the prices are. I always say that the internet tells you the truth, the shops don't. Another old cabinet. I mean, really, just fantastic quality. But who has the room nowadays? Everyone's downsizing. Who has the room for something like this? If you had a huge place, I know in America there's a lot of people have big houses. This would be perfect. Here in Europe, people, they're moving into small apartments. It's just hard to house something like this. Here is an old. Now that's a real gold leaf frame, And that map is original. Now, I would say that's the bargain of the day in this store. As I say, this store used to be crap. They've got a whole new team in here, I've noticed. It's a new team. It's great now. There's a lot of interesting stuff. Before, it was really so bad. I'm telling you, I think the staff must have been selling their stuff online, really. But that's a good bargain. That's a bargain for $90 equivalent, anyway, very similar in Swiss francs. Yeah, some nice old paintings of the Swiss Alps. What else do we have here? Well, that's quite sweet, isn't it? A little sort of kiddies wooden, what do you call it, a rocky swan, for want of a better description. Okay, it's like from the 1950s, 60s, nice clean condition. Would you pay $30 for that? I think a lot of people would. It's quite a nice, portable typewriter. I'm guessing this is like an inkwell stand. Quite nice, isn't it, for $48. I think that's a good price. It's very unusual with a wolf's head or a fox's head on it. And look at these old playing cards. These are old Swiss playing cards. So, yeah, they're quite interesting. I like them. Beer glasses, beer krugs, or beer steins. Whatever you like to call them. Quite nice, that one, isn't it? The ceramic one. Glazed ceramic. These are just run-of-the-mill from different parts of the world. Now, this section here I never even knew existed. Maybe it didn't exist when I came here last, or I just didn't see it. There's a whole huge, just sort of, when you come to the back, it's you can't really see. There's another sort of entryway. It leads to here. Auger Private, or Privat. Never heard of that typewriter company before. That's an old one. It's about 30s or 40s. Yeah, so I can sort of furniture. They must pay it. Because they're a charity, I guess they get this rent cheap. It's just a huge space, isn't it, to sell, what's basically junk and used furniture. A lot of money. Normally to pay around this area, to pay for an office sort of space that huge. Regulator clocks. Common as muck, as we say in English. Common as muck. Not worth a great deal. You know, there was that map again, that old... That's an original map too, by the way, hand-coloured. We passed that before. Got the video sequence back in front, didn't I? Yeah, blame it on the cold. Yeah, blame it on the cold. So we're going to give this this place a star rating afterwards. What do you think it should be? I have in mind what my star rating will be. There's a spirit level there, an old iron... Got quite a few of them. There's an old coach's lamp with a cracked glass, cracked pebble glass. I've had one of those too. Sold it. Some old ice skates. Solid, aren't they? Sometimes they only wear them once. You break your ankle, you never wear them again. A nice old coffee grinder. Sort of copper jug from sort of, whether it be from India or Pakistan or something like that. What are they called again? What are these called again? I've quite forgotten. Please remind me. Sort of travelling set. It's not a manicure set. I know that's for nails, isn't it? I'm losing my English. I've been here too long. Forgotten a lot of terms. I'm sure my Oddites will remind me. It's quite airy though here. I like that. It's got a nice sort of bright and cheery... Look, there's no gloom, there's no smell of dust or stink like some old cluttered junk stores have. It's got a modern feel to it. So I will give it that. That's an extra point. Not a fantastic range, but all is not lost. Look, there's an old sort of building set. Mecklen. It's like Meccano. It's very similar. Because we're going to my favourite junk store after this. You're getting another junk store... in one video, and they got always great stuff. You're gonna like it. Yeah. So, my star rating for this is... No! So, we're at my favorite junk store. Let's see what we have today. What are they, sort of hiking boots on top of that old chest? Not too sure. I think they are. Another one of those backpacks, you see. That's about the price they get. That's about it. I guess they're unusual for people overseas, but they're very common here, as I mentioned before. We have an old wall telephone. Looks to me like a reproduction, very much so. Yep. Yeah, that's a repro. I don't like it. Pine monstrosity. A nice old lamp. I've got a really nice Egyptian type 1930s one of those. I'll have to show you one of these days. I'll pull that out. It's in a box somewhere. Why is it in a box, you ask? Good question. I haven't got the right house for it yet. Now look at this. I like this old painting. It's like the hunter in an old inn, recounting his tale of the one he missed. What a nice painting. Also needs the right place, doesn't it? I can't imagine it in my home. I think it'd be nice in an old inn, wouldn't it? That would give a bit of ambience. It's quite well done, though. Yeah. Do you like it? I guess realism isn't so popular anymore, is it? People tend to like a sort of pot of paint splashed over a canvas stuck on their wall. I like realistic paintings, I must admit. I like something that's, you know, there's been love and attention put into it. Anyway, we'll get away from that subject before I infuriate those modern art lovers out there. So, what have we got here? Bits and bobs, old cast iron coal buckets, copper things. It's quite a nice copper. Oh, there's a horse saddle, old chest. These sort of things. What the hell is that up there? I quite like what they've done there with that mannequin. Ah, she's disguised herself as modern art to get to me. She knows how I feel about. Oh my God! Look at this. Look at this. Isn't that fabulous? This old French porcelain oven. I just love the colours too. Oh my God. I would be tempted to buy that. Oddit would kill me. I know. It's just so fantastic. That is art. That is art to me. 4,800 and something. Okay, you know, it's ancient, it's irreplaceable. If you had the right place, this would just be gorgeous. What a centerpiece. And is functional too. Would warm your dwelling. I love it. Love it. Couple of old radiograms there. Yes, quite nice. $180. Yeah, that's a lot. Considering we're going digital now and they're not going to be working anymore. But that's a nice one. I quite like that one. It's very sort of art deco. Yeah. That's sweet. Got some good colours there. I love this old sign too. Cafe, restaurant, Bahnhof. Bahnhof means train station. So this is a real old sign, probably from about the 50s, that would have been hanging above an old cafe or inn, restaurant, bar, pub, near a train station. Quite like that. I would have bought something like that years ago. Not this painting, that sign. I definitely would have bought something like that. Trying to really save it for the good items that I find. Really, the top end ones is what I'm saving myself for. So, look at this old. Now, that's old. That is old. That has some age, hasn't it? Very, well. Very dark themes, but it's a nice piece. If you had the right setting, it could be very dominating, couldn't it? In a sort of modern flat. Maybe too dominating. But, if you had an old sort of Tudor house, it's going to fit right in. I don't know whether this has a function or whether it's just a garden ornament that would have probably worked by electricity. Not sure about that. I do like this place. I must say, they've always got something interesting. It is really my favourite. Really is. And I'm happy you're joining me. It's like you come here too with me. You get to know the place. You get to know the different places. I've been to this one before. It's been in my tours before. Because you always guarantee. Oh, there's an old mangle. My aunt lost her little finger in one of those when she was a child. Vicious thing as they are. Vicious. Yeah. Yeah, you get to know them with me. This because the ones I like, I go back to. My cat is meowing outside the door again. I like that. I like that. Is it Japanese or Japanese style? It's very nice. What are they called again? Hummel? Is that a Hummel figure? You tell me, any experts on porcelain figures out there? And this old lithograph is lovely too, isn't it? A beautiful hand-carved frame as well. Sorry about the reflection of the lights. I've got it in a cabinet. I'll try my best. And this old pram, what is that? What do you think that is? 30s? 40s? It's got like a sort of porcelain handle. It's been damaged. A wickerwork body. And look at the wheels. That is old, isn't it? That could be even earlier. What do you reckon? 20s even? Could be even 1920s. And then look at this grand, look at this grand wardrobe. That is, I mean, it's just amazing. All by hand. All beautiful veneers. Just a quality piece. Quality. And, you know, okay, 1,945. They might sell it. You know, there's not a great demand for these anymore, but it's a great piece. So they definitely might... They might get a buyer for that. Usually these old prams have great suspension, don't they? So let's give it a bit of a rock. Look, you see it's still moving after I've let go of it. Comfortable ride for a baby, I would imagine. Yeah. What have we got here? Don't know what that is. Up here we have crucifixes. Religious stuff. Yep. Ah, a sweet little polar bear. Stuffed toy. Oh, I like that one there with his sort of oriental smoking jacket or whatever it is. Oriental pajamas. Yeah. I know a lot of you like sort of these little teddy bears and stuffed toys. And they've got some age, I think. Not that old, but some of them have got some age. Oh, look at this, what am I talking about? What the hell am I talking about? I don't know what that is. What is it, a grandfather bear? Or you tell me. Any bear experts, you tell me. And tell me what this is. I don't know. I have no idea what that is. Please let me know. Is it like a sort of knuckle duster from the Middle Ages? They're from a piano. I know that there were candle holders from a piano. I had some of those a few years back. I still have somewhere. What are these things here? I don't know anything today. Can anyone tell me what these little swan things are? Is that for sort of olives or bonbons? What is that for? I would love to know. I quite like them. I love the colours. I love the colours on them. Yeah, you'll have to tell me today. I don't know anything. I know what this is and I do like it. It's like an old department store, isn't it? The display... cabinet combined. I like that. If I had like an ancient curiosity shop, Oddie's Emporium, I would grab that. Oh, madam, I like your style. Your bob cut has me intrigued.
I'll meet you in Paris in spring, my dear. I'll be wearing a smoking jacket and fez, and you'll be a dream in green. Looking forward to it, darling.
Now look at this. Isn't this sweet? It's a little bear restaurant diorama. Isn't that fantastic? Somebody has made that by hand. I find that so sweet.
So, what do we have here? More crap. Can't see anything interesting there. And in the bowels of the store, sins are being committed. This woman here is committing an outrage upon this bedside cabinet. She is, creating a shabby chic nightmare. I don't know about you guys, but I'm really over this shabby chic. I can't even bear to hear that term anymore, you know. Decades and decades of patina and French polish stripped away, just so they can have an item that matches their tea cozy. I don't know. It reminds me of that Tales of the Unexpected episode where the eminent Sir John Gielgud plays the fake parson searching around the countryside for valuable pieces of furniture. He's really an antique dealer. I'll leave the link in the description if I remember. And he stumbles upon this farmhouse with these sort of three yokel farmers, and they have this Thomas Chippendale beautiful sideboard, and it's all painted white, and he knows what it is. He's trying to get it off them. If you haven't seen it, watch it. I'll leave the link. That's just one of my favorite episodes. Sir John Gielgud plays that part fantastically. Anyway, on a lighter note, and that was a lighter note anyway, because I love Tales of the Unexpected, I found this beautiful photo album. It's an antique Spanish photo album, and just look at the wonderful photos in it. It made my day. And the lady who is running the place let me take photographs of it, which really just, you know, photographs were really an art form back then. It's not just like a snap with your cell phone. It really was an art form. Check these out. Yeah, I'm always on the lookout for old photograph albums, especially good quality ones like this. They're getting few and far between nowadays. I don't always buy them. I just like to look through them. It's very magical looking back on the past. And the photos don't lie, unlike a painting. They just show you the real people. I love them. There's just something so special. And this hand-coloured one is just fantastic. Really nice. My buy for today wasn't anything special. It was this vintage Levi Strauss belt. I've got a few. This one, I guess, is probably from the 70s or 80s. Maybe I'm wrong. If anyone's out there, is an expert out there, feel free to correct me. It's got a nice bit of patina on it. Fits perfectly. $16 I paid. Not bad, I think. That was my buy. And I just want to show you something here that's very special to me. Even though I don't look at it much, it's been with me all these years. Check this out. This is my night light from when I was like a baby. And I've had it all these years. I've kept it. Just very nice memories of my parents. And it hasn't had a plug on it, I would estimate, since about 1975. And has the original bulb in it. So we're going to test it today to see whether it still works. The plastic, the rubbery plastic's feeling rather sort of starting to perish. You can see here there is no plug on it. Hasn't had one on for a long time. So let's check it out. I don't know exactly where they got this from. It's made in England. I can see that on the bottom. I've checked out on the internet. There are a couple of them. There are a couple of these that still survive. You can see Combex made this. They made quite a few different types of night lights. I think like Fred Flintstone ones, things like that. There's the bulb. It's like a bayonet car bulb, 12 volt. So this bulb is really old, and we're going to check it out today, see if it works. The wiring is very sketchy. It's very brittle, and it broke off as I was trying to work with it. Really, you should replace the whole wiring if you were going to use this again. I'm not. As you can see down the left, it broke off. I'm just going to test it today. So what I just do is I just cut that off and start afresh. And here we have revealed some new wiring underneath. And an extra little bit of a safety measure. I'm going to solder the ends. Here we have them soldered. I didn't really want to go to all this work. It's got a bit more than I had imagined. But it's better that way. As you can see, it's turning into a full-scale operation here. But as I say, this is just to check it out. Really should replace the whole wiring if you wanted to use it, and use an LED bulb as well. So there we have it, still working after all those decades. Amazing. Makes me feel very old looking at this. By the way, I'm in my workshop at the moment, deep in the bowels of my workshop, where all the magical things happen, like this, bringing this teddy bear back to life. I thought you might like to see that. Maybe you don't like to see it, but I'm showing you anyway. And if you wondered what that... There's the button on the back, by the way. If you wonder what that picture was to the left at the start, I'll show you that now. It's quite a nice old photo that I have in my possession. Check this out. Yeah, this old photo stays in my workshop to keep me company.
Looks to be like an early 1900s version of nymphs gazing into a garden pond. I'm not sure whether it's supposed to represent an ancient Greek fable. Any of you out there, if you know anything about this theme, what that's supposed to be. I like it though. It's sort of, it's soothing. Yeah, I found this on my travels, and it all ends up in the big dust pile that belongs to me. It's called preserving and protecting the past. It's my excuse anyway. Anyway, there's the label on the back. So I've shared a few things with you today, haven't I? Always something interesting to show, my dear Oddites. By the way, my latest historical feature on YouTube, which is an older Patreon video, is the Black Dahlia. You may or may not have received a notification for it. Because it's been demonetized, YouTube doesn't tend to notify a lot of people about it. It's a form of shadow banning. You know, you just didn't get the exposure. They sort of want you to make videos that they want you to make, and if you don't make them, yeah, this demonetization works on many levels. Not good. It just doesn't get the views. So I really would like you to look for it and thumb it up. Please share it. Share it with your friends. Yeah, I mean, it would be great if I could be, you know, like one of these YouTubers that just does a vlog and talks to people and makes millions and it's all happy and fluffy and positive and it's exactly what YouTube likes and, you know, you're pressing all the right buttons and... But I'm not. You know, I'm like the old retainer that YouTube grudgingly acknowledges but keeps me sort of locked downstairs so I don't embarrass their guests. Yeah, I think if YouTube had been around in my youth, I think I probably, it would have been a different story, you know. I might have got up in the big ranks, but I've started late in the day, but I think I'm giving an important contribution, and I know the older generation enjoy, and some of the young ones too, enjoy my stuff, so, you know, why should we be left out? Why should we be left out? Yeah? The less fluffy ones. I like making these type of videos, and I have a lot of viewers who do like them. It's a bit unfair that YouTube targets these type of videos, but that's why I have Patreon, and that's why I'm still going. My patrons make sure that I keep going. They're supporting me wonderfully, and I can keep making these type of videos. I don't make just vintage crime. I do other types too that YouTube do monetize, but these are also very popular. And unfortunately, it's just not worth my while making them for YouTube. That's why they appear on YouTube after they've been on Patreon for some time. So please show your support on YouTube. If you can't show it on Patreon, show it on YouTube by sharing my video with as many people as you can. And also, coming in the next few days is the teaser image giveaway on Patreon where you can win an Oddie mug. This time you don't have to know what case it is next that I'm presenting. All you have to do is leave a comment under the image in Patreon and it goes into a computer-generated random draw. You could be the winner of an Oddie mug of your choice, my friends. So look out for that. Anyway, I'm going to head off now. It's been great having you. Hope you enjoyed the tour. Let me know the things I didn't know. Anyway, take care. God bless, my friends. Until next time. Bye-bye.